India, good evening. Thanks for joining us on the News Hour. A day after the Congress released its manifesto that contained a number of promises, including freedom of personal laws, a full-blown political war has erupted, with the top BJP leaders slamming the Congress party, leading the attack on Congress Prime Minister Modi, who said that Congress's manifesto reflects the imprint of Muslim League that advocated for Pakistan as a different country for Muslims during the freedom movement. Addressing a rally in Saharanpur in Uttar Pradesh, Prime Minister Modi criticized the Congress manifesto and said that every page of the 47-page document reeks of an attempt to divide the country.
साथियों, कल कांग्रेस पार्टी ने एक झूठ का पुलिंदा जारी किया है, अपना घोषणा पत्र जारी किया है। झूठ का ये पुलिंदा कांग्रेस की एक बहुत बड़ी सच्चाई, कांग्रेस को बेनकाब करने वाला ये घोषणा पत्र है। आप देखिए, हर पन्ने पर भारत के टुकड़े करने की बू आ रही है। कांग्रेस के घोषणा पत्र में वही सोच झलकती है जो सोच आजादी के समय मुस्लिम लीग में थी। मुस्लिम लीग के उस समय के विचारों को कांग्रेस आज भारत पर थोपना चाहती है। मुस्लिम लीग की छाप वाले इस घोषणा पत्र में जो बचा खुचा हिस्सा था, उसमें वामपंथी लेफ्टिस्ट हावी हो गए हैं, तो ये भारत को पिछली शताब्दी में धकेलने का एजेंडा लेकर के आए हैं। क्या भारत को पिछली शताब्दी में धकेलने देंगे?
Other BJP leaders, including Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, Assam Chief Minister Hemanta Biswa Sarma, tore into the Congress party. While Nirmala called Congress's promises fiscally disastrous, Hemanta Biswa Sarma alleged that Congress manifesto seems like one that is meant for elections in Pakistan.
देखिए, जो कांग्रेस का घोषणा पत्र है, ये तुष्टीकरण का घोषणा पत्र है। लोग कोई नहीं चाहते है कि ट्रिपल तलाक फिर आए, कोई नहीं चाहते कि बाल विवाह दोबारा हो। वो लोग को सत्ता लाना है, सत्ता में आना है। कांग्रेस का तुष्टीकरण का जो राजनीति है, इसको हम लोग निंदा करता हूँ। और कांग्रेस का जो मैनिफेस्टो है, ये मैनिफेस्टो देखने से ऐसा लगता है कि ये भारत का चुनाव के लिए नहीं, कोई पाकिस्तान चुनाव के लिए ही ये घोषणा पत्र बनाया गया।
और वो साफ दिखाई पड़ता है कि उनके मैनिफेस्टो घोषणा पत्र में तो अब मुस्लिम लीग के फरमान भी दिखने लगे हैं। ये बात बहुत गंभीर और चिंताजनक है, क्योंकि मोदी जी की प्रचंड विजय जो अवश्यंभावी दिख रही है, उसके प्रति हताशा और कुंठा में कांग्रेस खतरनाक स्तर के तुष्टीकरण तक जा रही है। जब वो अपने घोषणा पत्र में ये कहते हैं कि वो अल्पसंख्यकों के निजी कानूनों को महत्व देकर रखेंगे, इसका अर्थ ये हो गया कि वो पर्सनल लॉ को बजाय समाज को राष्ट्र की मुख्य धारा में लाने के, उनके अंदर अलग पहचान और पृथकतावाद की सीमा पर ले जाने की बात करेंगे।
But it's not just the BJP that is going after the Congress party over its manifesto. Its own ally, the left, has not spared the Congress either. In fact, Kerala Chief Minister Pinaray Vijayan slammed the Congress manifesto, said it is keeping a criminal silence on CAA. He also questioned Congress's role during Babri Masjid demolition.
നമ്മുടെ രാജ്യത്തെ ധ്രുവീകരണത്തിനുള്ള അപകടകരമായ തന്ത്രമാണ് പൗരത്വ ഭേദഗതി നിയമം. ആ പൗരത്വ ഭേദഗതി നിയമം റദ്ദാക്കും എന്ന ഉറപ്പ് CPI മാനിഫെസ്റ്റോ നൽകുന്നു. കോൺഗ്രസിന്റെ മാനിഫെസ്റ്റോ ഈ കാര്യത്തിൽ കുറ്റകരമായ മൗനമാണ് പാലിക്കുന്നത്.
Interestingly, this comes under on a day when Congress's Sonia Gandhi launched a blistering attack on the Modi government. She alleged that the BJP government was making all possible attempts to destroy country's dignity and democracy.
दुर्भाग्य से आज हमारे देश में ऐसे नेता सत्ता में विराजमान हैं. मोदी जी खुद को महान मानकर देश और लोकतंत्र की मर्यादा का छिहारन कर रहे हैं. विपक्षी नेताओं को डराने धमकाने भाजपा में शामिल कराने के लिए तरह तरह के हथकंडे अपनाए जा रहे हैं. तो भाइयों और बहनों, आज हमारे देश का लोकतंत्र खतरे में है.
लोकतंत्र खतरे में है, सेज सोनिया गांधी. लेट्स ओपन दिस अप. संजू वर्मा, द नेशनल स्पोक्सपर्सन ऑफ द भारतीय जनता पार्टी, रतन शारदा, ऑथर, पॉलिटिकल एनालिस्ट अमरुजमान चौधरी, किशोर तिवारी, स्पोक्सपर्सन ऑफ द शिवसेना उद्धव ठाकरे फैक्शन, एडवोकेट सुभाष चंद्रन कंप्लीट्स दिस पैनल, पॉलिटिकल एनालिस्ट. गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू. रतन शारदा, बिफोर वी यू नो मेक दिस पॉलिटिकल, आई वॉन्ट यू टू टेल आवर व्यूअर्स what you think about the Congress's manifesto and why is it under attack from both the BJP and its own ally?
See, Pranesh, the first problem I have with that Congress in 2024 wants to go back to politics of 1970s, 1980s, talking of state government freebies, the Mai Baap Sarkar, then talking of the personal laws, Sharia laws, you know, opposition to UCC, then talking of caste census, which divides people, and will the caste centers or census also include caste in Muslims and Christian religion, or it will be only on Hindus? So all these issues that worry me, that when he talks, they talk about NSC and NSA to be under Parliament Select Committee. Do they want to destroy the autonomy of the past section that is expected of NSA? When they say talk to others about the to fighting terror, when they went on knees to Pakistan and USA to stop terror, and we had terror every month, are they going back to the same drawing board? I do not know. They talk of foreign policy where it was sterile, it was useless in you know, old age foreign policy. They want to go back to that foreign policy when you beg for space in the world, when you beg for space on the high table, and very sterile kind of non-alignment. Nobody believed you. We want to go for that. When they talk of EWS, when they say will be more inclusive, do they want to mean that EWS is not inclusive now? So what is the meaning about EWS opening to others? If they talk of freebies like left and right, giving 1 lakh here, 1 lakh there, they know Kerala is already bankrupt. They know Karnataka is begging for money. They know Telangana and Andhra are begging for money, and Bengal begging for money. They want to go back to bankrupt economy where we had to sell gold, keep our gold in UK, in the British treasuries. So there are so many things. They talk of dual GDP.
Right.
In 10 years, while Modi talks of a GDP in 5 years, if 50% women reservation, those who could not pass the women reservation bill, which was thrown by them, now they want to have a women's bill for 50% without raising the capacity of the women.
Right. So there are several points that, you know, that will need a deep dive.
Do they want back Hindu communal, they want communal violence bill back, in which Hindu was a convicted person in case of any riots? When they talk of stopping riot, what is their policy? When they talk of economic growth, what is their policy?
Right. I'm sure Kamruzaman Chaudhary ji is already taking notes. So when it's his turn, he can answer. But let me bring in Sanju Varma. Sanju Varma, the Prime Minister says that this reminds him of what the Muslim League stood for or did. Your leader, Himanta Biswa Sarma, has said that it seems like a manifesto for elections in Pakistan.
You know, Pranesh, it is election season and we all have to choose our words with discretion. But do you remember Manmohan Singh famously, or should I say infamously, in 2012 saying that Muslims should have the first right to natural resources? The Congress, its entire ideology is based on appeasement-oriented vote bank politics. And this is not Sanju Varma, but the famous Rajinder Sachar Committee of 2006, which says that for the longest time that the Congress ruled India, Muslims, 95.6% did not even have access to basic necessities like food, water, primary healthcare and sanitation. और आज देखिए मजे की बात ये है, 31% of प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना is allocated to minorities, particularly Muslims. 33% of PM Kisan is for minorities, particularly Muslims. 33.6% of Ayushman Bharat Yojana is for minorities, particularly Muslims. 36% of PM Ujwala Yojana beneficiaries are Muslims. And Pranesh, 37% of Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana beneficiaries are also minorities, particularly Muslims. So, pehli baat to ye, Congress only spoke, it made tall claims, it built flaky castles in the air. BJP walked the talk and talked the talk. My third point is this, very quickly. Muslim appeasement to Congress karegi hi, that we are all aware of. There is nothing new in that. But look at what some of the other key takeaways are, very quickly. Caste census. अरे भाई साहब कास्ट सेंसस राहुल गांधी चिल्ला चिल्ला के बोलते हैं हम कास्ट सेंसस करेंगे. वी वांट टू बी फेयर टू द ओबीसी कम्युनिटी, वी वांट टू बी फेयर टू दलित्स. द कांग्रेस स्पेंट 4986 करोड़ रुपीस टू कंडक्ट अ कास्ट सेंसस इन 2011-2014 तक तो कांग्रेस की सरकार थी. कास्ट सेंसस के डिटेल्स आपने बाहर क्यों नहीं किए. माई सेकेंड पॉइंट, दे आर सेइंग वी विल मेक एमएसपी इनटू अ लीगल राइट. भाई साहब today in 23 crops MSP is given by Modi government. MSP ko aaj aap legal right banane ki baat kar rahe ho under the UPA. Pranesh, for 10 years from 2004 to 2014, everybody knows rice and wheat, or should I say paddy and wheat, are the two crops which account for 64% of the MSP payout. Do you know something? Only 2 lakh crore worth of rice / paddy and wheat were procured at MSP in the 10 years of UPA 1 and UPA.
Right.
And guess what the number is for the last 10 years? 18 lakh crore of paddy and wheat has been procured at MSP by the BJP-led Narendra Modi government. So Congress, sirf hawa mein hawa hawai baat karna janti hai, zameen par all that they do is shagufa chhodna. But public bahut samajhdar hai, aapke shagufa chhodne se kuch nahi hoga, aapko aapki sahi worth June 4th ko pata
padega. No, they are saying that democracy is under attack. There is dictatorship. We'll come to that, Sanjeev Varma. But Kamruzzaman Chaudhary, you know, I don't know how would you respond to what the BJP is. Yeah. The BJP is saying that this is minority appeasement. Your ally left is saying that you betrayed the Muslims. How would you respond?
Yeah, Pranesh, you know, Narendra Modi ji or Hemanta Biswa Sarma or the entire ecosystem, they could have criticized our manifesto called the Nyay Patra on its merit. But for that, you know, these people, they need to have a basic grasp of the entire subject. Even Modi's script writers or the Hemanta Biswa Sarma script writers are aware of their limitations. So they rather stick him to this patent, you know, Hindu-Muslim, Pakistan-Muslim League. You know, this is totally shameful. A prime minister of the country discussing an opposition's manifesto, which most of the independent observers have praised it and termed it as a necessity for the future of India. If we speak about in the manifesto about the anti-defection law, if we speak about providing 30 lakh government vacant jobs, if we speak about the uniform GST rates, if we speak about the Hissedari Niyay, if we speak about scrapping the Agnipath, now you come back to the minority appeasement. What type of minority appeasement are you speaking about? Subsequent research data have proved that over the last 10 years, let me cite you two governments data point out here. All India Depth and Investment Survey, we call them AIDS, and the Periodic Labor Force Survey, PLFS, shows that the Muslims in this country have the lowest asset and consumption levels among major religious group in India. Even the Muslim upper caste are poorer than the Hindu OBCs. So is it not the duty of the
Chaudhary,
nation?
Are you suggesting that the Muslims became poor after 2014? That they were uber rich before 2014? Mr. Chaudhary?
No, wait. Satchar committee report was before BJP came to power.
Pranesh, if you want to pick and talk about...
No, no, I am not picking, sir. Now, Kamruzzaman.
No, no.
No, no. No, no. Kamruzzaman Chaudhary, you made the point. I am not the one picking on any point. I asked you a generic question. Of what you are speaking, I asked you that question. Now you are going after me. Aisa toh mat kijiye, please.
सच्चर कमेटी रिपोर्ट कब आई थी पूछी है
ना लेट मी यू गिव द अदर सर्विस फाइव सेकंड्स आई एम द ओनली वन हु इज गोइंग टू डिफेंड द डाटा
नो नो सो यू डिफेंड द डाटा सो नोबडी इज इंटरप्टिंग
लुक द किसान न्याय
कंबू समान चौधरी प्लीज लेट्स बी फेयर व्हेन संजू वर्मा हैजंट इंटरप्टेड रतन शारदा हैजंट इंटरप्टेड हु इज इंटरप्टिंग यू डिफेंड द डाटा आई एम गिविंग यू टाइम टू डिफेंड इट
व्हाई शुड नो
बी अ मोनोलॉग बाय दिस गाय
नो नो व्हाई डू यू वांट टू पिक एंड से that any targeted development to the particularly economically downtrodden
but economically downtrodden
India,
no one minute but historically they have been economically ideas. downtrodden. What did the Congress do? Are you suggesting, Mr. Kamruzzaman Chaudhary, look, let's not mislead the people who are watching, ki 2014 se pehle the economic conditions of Muslims wo change ho gaya suddenly after 2014? That is not the case, you know it yourself. Now, let me ask you this. I also have a copy, sir. Please. Rukiye.
Okay, fine.
This, let's go point by point. Please, sir, I beg your indulgence, please. It says we promise not to interfere with personal choices of food and dress, to love and marry, and to travel and reside in any part of India. Kaya restriction, all laws and rules that interfere unreasonably with personal freedoms will be repealed. Which are these laws, sir?
Okay, fine. Point by point. Pranesh.
Point by point. Yeah, which are these laws?
Point by point, please. Point by point. Okay, fine. Now you come to the Gujarat.
No, no. Sanju Verma ji, I'll come to you. Let him just answer this one.
What does it say? Abolition. No, no. What does the Gujarat Disturbed Area Act say? What is the recent executive order of the Assam government say regarding to selling of plots and houses to Muslims? There are plenty lot of issues like this when the hijab ban was issued in the schools of Karnataka. What happened to the Azan issue? You are targeting the
what happened to the Azan issue? The matter went to the High Court. Now it is pending with the Supreme Court. Kamruzzaman Chaudhary. Kamruzzaman Chaudhary, this is not going to work. Sanju Verma, quick response.
Instead of you have Pranesh, now I don't want to be heckled. You have to moderate.
No. All faders will be down. One person speaks at a time. Yes.
You know, Pranesh, this man Kamru has the habit of coming on every debate. He will never say ki Congress ne kya kya kiya ya kya kya nahi kiya. But he will give you a long list. BJP ne ye nahi kiya, Modi ji ne ye nahi kiya, Amit Shah ne wo nahi kiya. Hum victim hai. Victim card khelna band karo. Public badi samajhdar hai. They are not going to be taken in by your victim card. First and foremost, hijab ban. Hijab ban in schools, colleges or educational institutions which come under the Karnataka State Education Act of 1984 was upheld by the Karnataka High Court. The matter is now pending before a larger 7-judge bench of the Supreme Court. So Karnataka High Court ne hijab ban ko actually upheld kiya tha saying hijab is not integral to Islam. Point number one. Point number two, azan jo aap din mein 5 baar padhna chahte ho. No community was targeted. The Bombay High Court judgment of 2016 and 2021 clearly says that there will be no blaring of loudspeakers post 10 p.m. in the night till 6 a.m. in the morning. Whether it is for blaring azan out of loudspeakers or whether it is for doing a jagrata or whether it is for doing a Hanuman Jayanti ka paath or whether it is for doing, Bhagwan Ram ko invoke karne ka koi paath. So it applies to everyone. No loudspeakers will blare between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m. But a certain community brazenly has been flouting both the Bombay High Court judgments of 2016 and 2021. You have to just go to places like Baikala and Nala Sopara in Mumbai to realize how for a certain community, they feel they are above the law. Law of the land inke liye exist nahi karta. My way or the highway. That is what they believe in. Now my third point. You know, can you imagine Hamid Ansari, the uncle of dreaded gangster Mukhtar Ansari, who just died a few days back. After being the vice president of India for 10 long years, he holds a conference with इंडियन इस्लामिक मुस्लिम कॉन्फ्रेंस IAMC इन 2022 और वहां ये क्या बोलते हैं जनाब, एंड बाय द वे IAMC इज फंडेड बाय जमाते इस्लामी एंड जमातुद दावा, टू टेरर आउटफिट्स. व्हाट डज हामिद अंसारी से? ही सेज मुस्लिम्स आर ट्रीटेड लाइक सेकंड क्लास सिटीजंस इन इंडिया. ये 10 साल वाइस प्रेसिडेंट होने के बावजूद, एंड शुड आई रिमाइंड योर ऑडियंस दैट हामिद अंसारी इज अ करियर कांग्रेस पर्सन. तो बेसिकली कांग्रेस के डीएनए में विक्टिम कार्ड खेलना.
लेट्स ब्रिंग इन द कांग्रेसेस अलाय एडवोकेट सुभाष चंद्रन, व्हाट डू यू मेक ऑफ द मैनिफेस्टो एंड व्हाट केरला चीफ मिनिस्टर मिस्टर विजयन हैज सेड?
एक्चुअली मैडम, वी आर लुकिंग दिस मैनिफेस्टो, कांग्रेस मैनिफेस्टो, इन अ डिफरेंट वे. एक्चुअली कांग्रेस शुड हैव देयर इनफ टू से they will scrap some laws like CAA and the Citizenship Amendment Act and the other draconian laws like UAPA and this PMLA Act. Because see, we have witnessed enough in this country how this government has utilized these draconian laws to target the opposition leaders and their opponents in this country. So many activists, many political leaders are arrested under these draconian laws, and the left parties has categorically stated in their manifestos that the scrapping of the CAA and the UAPA.
No,
and
but
the
Mr. PMLA. Chandran, why do you think that Congress has not done it? What is the reason?
No, actually, that's why we are. That is our criticism from the left side.
No, why do you think that has happened? What do you think is the reason?
So actually, the problem is this: the Congress is playing. Sometimes they are fearing from the North India or from the Central India, they may lose this may use by the BJP for their political propaganda. As now, what they are doing like this? Now the Prime Minister has started Tughlai gang, the urban Naxals, then the left extremists. So now the people of this country, we should not underestimate the people of the country. They are enough, means courageous.
No, I agree with you completely on the last point. Rahul Gandhi has underestimated the voters. He believed that voters in South India are smarter than the voters in North India. But you tell me, sir, if you are so miffed with the Congress's manifesto, you are calling out. I don't understand this, Mr. Chandran. If the left believes that the Congress is being hypocritical in not actually standing for what you believe is the core objective of a Team India, why are you still in the alliance?
A part of the India alliance, we have our own ideology, we have our own manifestos, and we have published, we have placed that before the people of this country. Now, what is our opinion, what is our criticism is the Congress should have. They're enough to say that they will, if they come to the power, if the India Alliance will come to the power, they should scrap this draconian laws, because we have noticed.
Which draconian law are you talking about? Are you talking about the UAPA that the left manifesto
UAPA
wants to?
And the PMLA.
Do you know that the Kerala police has also invoked UAPA? The Kerala police comes under the Kerala government ruled by your party. Why are you using it if it is draconian?
The manifesto of the CPM,
all of you have a problem with electoral bonds, yet you've taken money.
Have you gone through that might be done by the Kerala police, and we are criticizing that. Have you gone through the manifesto of the CPM? Sir, the manifesto published day before yesterday by the CPM,
So day before you realize that the UAPA is draconian?
So the left party's manifesto categorically says that
किशोर तिवारी जी, आपने अभी तक बोला नहीं है और शांति से आप सुन रहे हैं, शायद पता नहीं नाराज लग रहे हैं आप. कांग्रेस मैनिफेस्टो से नाराज हैं या मुझसे नाराज हैं आप?
अरे प्रणेश, आप बोलने देंगे तो आदमी बोलेगा.
आपका शो है सर, आप बोलिए.
बोलता हूँ ना, एक बात मैं बताऊ, मैं कांग्रेस हाईकमांड का शुक्रगुजार हूं कि कोर इश्यूज उन्होंने इस मैनिफेस्टो में लाए, जैसे कि एग्रेरियन क्राइसिस, रूरल क्राइसिस, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, हेल्थ का इशू, एजुकेशन का इशू, यह सब कुछ है. दूसरा, जो भारत के संविधान पे जो डेमोक्रेटिक राइट्स बाबा साहेब आम्बेडकर ने दिए हैं, उस पर जो कठुराघात हो रहा है, जो जैसे कि ईडी है, सीबीआई है, इसका दुरुपयोग हो रहा है, उस पर भी बोला है, लेकिन शिवसेना एक राइट विंग हिंदू पार्टी है, वो चाहती है कि देश कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन के हिसाब से चले, एनीथिंग बियॉन्ड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एनी लिबर्टी टू एनी रिलीजन वी आर नॉट विद देम। तो हमारा एजेंडा हमारा है, हम चाहते हैं।
किशोर तिवारी जी, अब आप ये बताइए कि प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी ने कहा है कि ये मुस्लिम लीग के तरह है, उस पे आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
पंत प्रधान जी है ना, ये चुनाव पूरा मोदी जी ये पूरा चुनाव हिंदू मुसलमान तुष्टीकरण इस पर लाना चाहते हैं। मोदी जी के 10 साल हो गए हैं, मोदी जी को अपनी उपलब्धियों पे गिनना चाहिए। मोदी जी जो उपलब्धियां बताते हैं उसको लोग सीरियसली ले रहे या नहीं ले रहे? मोदी जी के भाषण में कांग्रेस को गालियां दी जाती है, 70% पोर्शन तो वो विपक्ष को।
अच्छा ये बताइए, सोनिया गांधी जी ने कहा है कि देश में डिक्टेटरशिप है।
नहीं है, महाराष्ट्र से तो लगता है हमें उद्धव जी की सरकार जैसी गिराई गई, होम मिनिस्टर को जेल में रखा गया।
ओके,
दो चीफ मिनिस्टर संजू वर्मा के अंदर है।
रेस्पॉन्ड टू योर गुड फ्रेंड।
अच्छा, किशोर तिवारी जी ने काफी कुछ कहा, अभी मुझे अपेक्षा है कि वो बड़ी ध्यान से मेरी बात भी सुनेंगे, मैं बड़े ध्यान से उनको सुन रही थी। वी आर हैविंग अ वेरी एंगेजिंग डिबेट प्रणेश, थैंक्स टू यू फॉर मॉडरेटिंग इट सो ब्रिलियंटली। यू नो प्रणेश, अभी महाराष्ट्र में कांग्रेस और उद्धव सेना के बीच का क्या समीकरण है, लेट मी टेल यू। उद्धव सेना स्पोक टू शरद पवार, दे फाइनलाइज्ड अ कैंडिडेट फॉर भिवंडी, राहुल गांधी और कांग्रेस से किसी ने पूछा ही नहीं, कांग्रेस नाराज फूफा बनकर बैठ गई। उद्धव सेना डिसाइडेड टू फील्ड गजानंद कीर्तिकर, द करंट सिटिंग एमपी फ्रॉम मुंबई नॉर्थ वेस्ट, उनके बेटे अमोल कीर्तिकर को उद्धव सेना ने कहा दिस विल बी आवर कैंडिडेट फ्रॉम मुंबई नॉर्थ वेस्ट। राहुल गांधी को किसी ने खबर नहीं की ना पूछा, शरद पवार को किसी ने खबर नहीं की ना पूछा। कैन आई प्लीज फिनिश, आई डिड नॉट हैव टू, कैन आई फिनिश
प्रणेश? ऑफ कोर्स सर, आई विल कम टू यू, लेट हर मेक अ पॉइंट, आई विल कम टू यू फॉर अ रिस्पांस।
व्हाई डू यू थिंक संजय निरुपम लेफ्ट? बिकॉज संजय निरुपम हैज बीन कॉन्टेस्टिंग फ्रॉम मुंबई नॉर्थ वेस्ट, ऑब्वियसली ही लॉस्ट टू गजानंद कीर्तिकर इन लोकसभा 2019, बट संजय निरुपम इज नोन एज वन ऑफ द कांग्रेसी बाहुबलीज ऑफ मुंबई नॉर्थ वेस्ट। तो कहने का तात्पर्य यह है कि उद्धव ठाकरे फिलहाल अपनी अकेली गाड़ी चला रहे हैं, ना वो शरद पवार की सुनते हैं ना वो राहुल गांधी की सुनते हैं। खैर, राहुल गांधी की तो उनके खुद के पार्टी के कार्यकर्ता नहीं सुनते, बट इन 30 सेकंड्स आई विल टेल यू वन थिंग, व्हिच इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेट इन टर्म्स ऑफ लोकसभा सीट्स आफ्टर उत्तर प्रदेश। उत्तर प्रदेश हैज 8080 सीट्स, यू नो महाराष्ट्र हैज 48 सीट्स। इन 20 सेकंड्स आई विल टेल यू दिस, हु इज द बाहुबली ऑफ नांदेड? अशोक चव्हाण। प्लीज आई एम फिनिशिंग इन 20 सेकंड्स, वेट फॉर योर टर्न। हु इज द बाहुबली ऑफ नांदेड? अशोक चव्हाण। टुडे ही इज विद द बीजेपी, ही जंप्ड शिप फ्रॉम द कांग्रेस। हु इज द बाहुबली ऑफ जलगांव? अनिल भाईदास पाटिल, ही लेफ्ट शरद पवार एंड जॉइन द बीजेपी। हु इज द बाहुबली ऑफ लातूर? इट इज अगेन संजय भानसोड़े, ही लेफ्ट शरद पवार एंड जॉइन द बीजेपी। हु आर द बाहुबलीज ऑफ रायगढ़ डिस्ट्रिक्ट? इट इज द फादर डॉटर डुओ ऑफ सुनील तत्करे एंड अदिति तत्करे, इवन दे लेफ्ट शरद पवार।
लेट्स गेट अ रिस्पांस, इवन कमरू जमान चौधरी वांट्स टू काउंटर व्हाट यू आर सेइंग। यस कमरू जमान जी,
प्रणेश आई विल ऐड,
आ रहा हूं सर, मैं आपके पास आ रहा हूं इसके बाद।
या प्रणेश, फाइनली यू नो आउट ऑफ द out of every four candidates that the BJP has given, one is a turncoat Mir Jafar from some other party into the Bharatiya Janata Party. That's why Congress in its Nyaya Patra has brought out a clause that any such turncoat Mir Jafar will have to go to the voters once again before trying to come and play resort politics. Like happened, what happened in Maharashtra, what happened in Madhya Pradesh, what was about to happen in Rajasthan. So that is the way, you know, Narendra Modi, you know, he has been mentioned in this election in some small columns of the newspapers. Somehow or the other, his voice is not being resonated across to the voters. Because Ram Mandir is already a gone case. It is done.
No, it's Sanju Verma. It is actually a departure from the usual narrative. Kamru Zaman Chaudhary is saying that Prime Minister Modi has got less coverage. Usually the Congress says that, look, the media is hijacked. So I don't know what has got him to say that. But okay, quickly, Kishore Tiwari ji, come in, make your point. Ratan Sharda, I'm coming to you after this.
Can I just come in?
No. Ma'am, Kishore Tiwari, responding to what you just said.
I would like to add with Sanju. Yeah. Sanju, I would like to add that in Maharashtra, you are losing almost all seats. In 48 seats, around 45 seats, there is no issue. One-to-one fight is going on. I do agree. On a 3 seats, there is a tussle. But most of the seats allotted to the Shiv Sena, we are contesting only those seats. And other 3 seats dispute will be resolved.
Now, I need to respond.
And you are losing the election.
You can't give a free run to these guys who are making zero sense.
Kishore Tiwari, you will be Kishore Tiwari ji has turned into a cephalologist. Sanju Verma, quick response.
I need to come in. Yes, now, Pranesh, I will speak if you allow me uninterrupted because, you know...
Uninterrupted, 1 minute, ma'am. Then I have to bring in the others.
Pranesh, if you look at the history of Maharashtra Lok Sabha elections and assembly elections of the last... 30-40 years, you will find... Again, Pranesh, I refuse to debate like this.
Kishore Tiwari ji, aapke friend hai, bolne dijiye, sir, please.
No, you can't be mollycoddling him like this because
please,
I am
please,
quite...
Please, faders down, one person speaks at a time, please.
Thank you. Thank you for keeping his fader down because he does not understand...
No, ma'am, let's not get personal.
Yes.
Make your point.
So, Pranesh, in the last 30-40 years, I was going through some data and I found something very interesting. Chahe... कांग्रेस पार्टी हो चाहे उद्धव सेना हो चाहे शरद पवार वाली एनसीपी का फैक्शन हो इन नो लोकसभा इलेक्शन इन नो असेंबली इलेक्शन देयर एवरेज वोट शेयर हैज एवर क्रॉस्ड 16% or 17% बारिंग लोकसभा 2019 व्हेन द शिवसेना उद्धव फैक्शन हैड अ 24% वोट शेयर अभी ये कहते हैं मीर जाफर अरे हमको हमारी पीठ में छुरा भोंक दिया हाउ मेनी सीट्स डिड देवेंद्र फडणवीस double engine Sarkar win in assembly elections in Maharashtra 2019. We won 105 seats. How many did Uddhav Sena win? 56 seats. How many did Congress win? 44. How many did Sharad Pawar win? 54. Aray bhai, largest party was BJP with 105 seats. And
No, that's Uddhav okay. All this is borne out by data. 1 minute. I want to bring in Kamru Zamanji. You know, you were talking about anti-defection and Mir Jafar's. सर व्हाट इज इट दैट यू होल्डिंग सर आप बोल भी सकते हैं मैं आपसे ये पूछना चाहता हूं इनफैक्ट एज वी यू नो डिबेट केटीआर हैज पुट आउट अ ट्वीट सर ही सेज कांग्रेस प्रीचेस समथिंग डज द एग्जैक्ट ऑपोजिट इन तेलंगाना रिसेंटली देव अनाउंस्ड एन एमपी टिकट टू वन बीआरएस एमएलए ऑल्सो एडमिटेड अनदर बीआरएस एमएलए बोथ ऑफ हुम आर स्टिल हैंगिंग ऑन टू देयर सीट्स राहुल गांधी जी व्हाई डोंट यू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट दैट यू आर अ पार्टी You're not a party of hypocrites. Ab sir, iska jawab de dijiye. Mir Jafar.
Nahi, nahle pe dahla, boss. Hum, nahi, nahi, suniye. Hum chudiya pehen kar election ka maidan mein nahi aaye. Jo jisko jis aukat mein bhasha samajh mein aata hai.
But Kamru Zaman Chaudhary, if that is, then how are you a party with difference?
The point is that.
Then why are you calling?
BJP करे तो रामलीला और हम करे तो रासलीला वाह भाई वाह
रतन शारदा
कानून नहीं बनता तब तक जो है कि हम भी वही करेंगे
ओके रतन शारदा
देखिए जिस तरह से इन्होंने चूड़ियां पहनने की बात की है कि 50% रिजर्वेशन स्त्रियों को देंगे कैसे
ये अभी मैं सर यू नो आई जस्ट वांट टू से दिस यू बिफोर यू फिनिश योर पॉइंट इट्स सो फनी अभी आपसे बोलने से पहले इन्होंने पेपर उठाया था उस पे महिला न्याय कुछ ऐसा लिखा हुआ था और अभी ये बोल रहे चूड़ियों हमने चूड़ियां नहीं पहनी है तो अब मैं क्या ही बोलूं बट ठीक है सर
मिसोजिन इनका मिसोजिन खुल के आती है इनकी पार्टी की महिलाएं इनके ऊपर दावा करती है कि हमारे साथ मोलेस्टेशन हुआ तो नेता उनको पार्टी से निकाल देते हैं ये कहेंगे 50% रिजर्वेशन ऑफ वुमेन नाउ कमिंग टू इश्यूज दैट वी फॉरगेट अगेन एंड अगेन They said that we'll scrap people with the communists, they will scrap CA. Why? CA is a communal law. Uniform Civil Code is a secular law, but they will oppose both. And what grounds? They don't want to support the minorities in Pakistan who are being persecuted. So why do they want to scrap it? They want them to die in utter poverty, in utter neglect, in utter losing their daughters and women. Then they talk of restoring statehood of Jammu Kashmir. Congress, how do you want to restore the statehood? Do you want to scrap 370? That's what you said. So are you going to scrap 370 challenge you to do it? And when this 370 was removed, that is the time when to put better control in Valley. Jammu Kashmir was made a union territory. BJP has clearly said it will go back to state assembly and have elections. So what are you trying to do? When you say that you will see the communal violence is reduced, I raise this point again, time and again. Will you go back to communal violence bill, which targeted Hindus? Then you talk of equal rights for minorities and majority. Right to education, you brought in amendment where the right to education, responsibility of minority institutions are removed. They were exempted. Why don't they have good institutions like best church schools and best colleges? They should not serve the society. Will you remove that?
But Ratan Chadha ji, what should the Congress do? Congress is under attack from both the BJP and the left for two different reasons.
Because they are trying to see, they are on one side, they are going extreme left. With loony left, Ratan Chadha ji, going with extreme communal parties. They talk of EM is hacked. Are they going to support EVM if they win the election? Where they win the election, is the EVM okay or not okay? You try to create distrust among people on these issues. When you say, okay, remove UAPA, because Communist Party doesn't like, Naxal has been reduced to lowest possible effectiveness now today.
Last word on the show, Sanju Verma, answer what Sonia Gandhi said.
Entire BOC.
Pranesh, now Congress in Rajasthan. You have to allow me a free run without being interrupted and heckled by Mr. Tiwari and Kamru. Thank you. What did Sonia Gandhi say? She said, Lok Tantra ka cheer haran ho raha hai. Sonia Gandhi ji, after the February 2002 Gujarat riots, Congress party maligned, hounded, targeted and attacked Narendra Modi for 20 years. He was given an unconditional clean chit by the Supreme Court in June 2022. Supreme Court said there was no criminal conspiracy by Narendra Modi. Aaj tak, aaj bhi aap Narendra Modi ko hound karte ho, malign karte ho. Then the date was 26 November 2005. Sohrabuddin died. You hounded Amit Shah for 13 years. Bombay High Court in 2016 gave a clean chit to Amit Shah. Supreme Court gave a clean chit to Amit Shah in 2018. Aaj bhi on debates, you malign and undermine the credibility of Amit Shah. Tab democracy khatre mein nahi thi? Tab loktantra khatre mein nahi hai? When you undermine the Supreme Court, the 6th of December 1992, Babri Masjid demolition, for 28 years, L.K. Advani, Uma Bharti, Kalyan Singh were all hounded. It was in 2020 that the Supreme Court gave a clean chit to L.K. Advani. You kept hounding him for 28 years. Tab loktantra, ganatantra, samvidhan khatre mein nahi tha? Isliye Sonia Gandhi ji, when you talk about samvidhan khatre mein hai, loktantra khatre mein hai, please remember June 1975, the horrifying emergency. Please remember more than 60 million people unko jabran nasbandi karwani padi thi thanks to Sanjay Gandhi. Please remember Rajiv Gandhi who wanted to bring in the Anti-Defamation Bill in 1988. Thank God it never passed muster.
And it's rather strange that top Congress leaders except Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary haven't uttered any word on the attack on the NIA team in Bengal. Let's leave it at that. We've run out of time completely. Sanju Verma, Ratan Sharda, Kamru Zaman, Chaudhary, Kishore Tiwari ji, Advocate Subhash Chandran. Thank you for joining us on the News Hour.